Hello and welcome back to my channel, Men with Mare. Right, you all, I am back. I am sorry for the delay. I'm feeling, you know, rejuvenated a bit now that the book is out and I'm receiving some feedback that's making me feel really good about doing it, even though I got scared to death about releasing it, even though it was released. And I just suddenly was like, it just felt very, very, very vulnerable. Thank you to anyone and everyone that has purchased this. It has meant so much to me. So I am going to be doing an artist I've never done before, but I have gotten requested a lot, and it's Tom Walker. I don't know him. Don't even know what his voice sounds like. All right. But it's a new song out. And I feel like really, really, really switching it up. And I know that I've gotten a lot of requests for other songs and other artists, and they are coming. I promise you that they are coming. Please bear with me. I had a week, felt pretty down. I felt really weird, a lot of emotions coming up, but I'm getting better. So let's do this. All right, I think it's called Burn. Tom Walker, Burn.
I watch as my whole world's going up in flames.
Okay, all right. I like this. I like his voice. I'm realizing that I haven't done many men on my channel. I did Hozier. Is that it? I think that's it. So it's just very striking. So I watch as my world's going up in flames. So kind of how I felt about a year ago.
Through the black smoke, I can see your face. Embers they rain as the walls come down. Where do we go when the lights go out? I give you my blood, my sweat, my tears, and all you ever did was leave me here. Cause you love the hurt. Send me.
I'm sorry. Wow. I don't know what to think right now. There's an intensity. There's a lot of intensity there. Wow. I have chills all up and down my arms. That was unexpected. And I feel it. I feel it. It's so okay. I gotta go back because I just shook me and I felt it very deeply. I feel the anger. I feel like goddess Kali vibes. If you know, you know. I'm feeling like this person has just been treated really poorly and left in the ashes, really.
Where do we go when the lights go out? I gave you my blood, my sweat, my tears, and all you ever did was leave me here. You love the hurt. Set me on fire just to watch me on my knees. My heart, it bleeds while you pour gasoline all over me. Set me on fire cause you love the hurt. Set me on fire just to watch me. What would you do if you lost control?
Okay. Sorry, I don't know what to... Wow. I know what he means when he's saying, like, set me on fire because you like the hurt. It sounds like self-sabotage. It sounds like someone who is like addicted to shame. Have you heard of this? Like where there are people who are so afraid of being abandoned that they abandon first and hurt people first so that they don't have to feel the pain of being left or hurt or all of the things that could happen but might not ever. Comes from like a deep place of, you know, maybe childhood trauma and distrust, things like that. So I kind of love this. I love it. I feel it. It makes me want to go up a bonfire and just like, you know, take all the books left over and just
throw them in there.
But the different type of vibes, like the sounds in the background, they're like throw just I feel like I'm getting hit in a lot of different directions. Okay.
How would you feel if your dreams were sold? With both your hands tied and your taped up mouth. Me on my knees, my heart, it bleeds. While you put gasoline all over me. Set me on fire, cause you love the hurt. Set me on fire, just to watch me.
Oh my gosh. That was intense. Ooh, it's giving me narcissistic personality disorder, like the person that's doing this to them, or psychopathy, you know, where people are psychopaths, really kind of like American Psycho, even though you like have undying love or you want to treat somebody so well, but they like get a sick thrill out of hurting you or feeding you lies, feeding you dreams.
Oh, we're gonna build a life together and buy a house together.
And then that person just ends up, you know, putting tape over your mouth, tying your hands behind you.
And lighting you on fire.
Oh, I get it. I see that, but it does give me a lot of themes around just being used and being a victim of, you know, narcissism. Definitely. You know that feeling like if somebody's just like pouring gasoline on you, like they're okay watching you burn. And saying, like, gave you my blood, sweat, and tears. I mean, I wonder what he's talking about. Love to know exactly what he's talking about, like, exactly what the subject is. But seeing it from a psychoanalytic lens, I can see themes around self-sabotage, narcissism, abandonment issues, psychopathy, like someone really getting a thrill out of harming other people and not feeling anything about it. For antisocial personality disorder, about 80% of people that are in prison have that type of diagnosis. And that's just because like they just lack empathy and remorse. They just don't have any. And so it sounds like the way that he is being burned is at the stake, but oh my gosh. But you know what this also gives me? One of the first things, I think it was taken out of my book, Hey Addiction, Thanks for Nothing. I did my proposal. I talked about how, I'll talk about people with addiction issues. It's like they're on fire and then the loved ones are on the outside, like doing everything that they can to put that fire out, but they're not realizing that they're catching fire and it's actually harming them so badly. So it makes me think about that, loved ones of addicts too, that have dealt with that type of feeling of being used and like why they're like, I will do anything to help you. It's like, no, I'm just going to keep harming you. Wow. Okay. That was something else. Awesome. Shocking. Beautiful. I still have some like chills going up and down my arms. Okay. All right. I hope you all enjoyed this one. You all take care.